Well, he is top chef master in one of Chicago's most famous restaurateurs. Well, this morning, Rick Bayless wants to bring Mexico to your holiday table one plate at a time. Hey, good morning to you, Rick. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning. How are you doing this morning?
Doing pretty good. I bet you guys are probably a bit colder than we are here in Sacramento, although we've been pretty cold. In the meantime, we got Christmas coming right up. And you want to talk about Mexican food for Christmas? When I first saw I was doing this interview with you, I was like, really?
Well, I have to say that a lot of people don't think about Mexican food at all during the holidays. They have their ritual of what they want to make. But I want to pitch guacamole to you because I think guacamole has an absolute perfect place at holiday parties. Well, first of all, just think about the color. I mean, the stuff is green and you usually add something red to it. So it's perfect that way. But probably more important is that the avocados are absolutely at the peak of their season. And that's when you're going to get the creamiest guacamole. But now, a lot of times people don't know how to choose the ripest and best avocado for making guacamole. So I've got these beautiful avocados from Mexico here. And I'm going to show you what you look for. When you want to get an avocado that is ready for making guacamole, you push on the big bulbous end here. And if it gives a little bit, that says it's going to be creamy on the inside. Then you flip it around. There's this little stem end that you pull off there. And then you cut around the pit. Mm-hmm. And when you get right back to where you started here, you can twist the two sides apart. And you'll notice that the pit will stick in one side. I usually just lodge the end of my knife into it like that. And then scoop that flesh right out from the skin. Now, these are Haas avocados, so they have that kind of tougher skin, which allows you just to scoop that creamy flesh right out
so
of there.
Rick, and I know you're getting to it real quick here. I don't want to jump in here, but you obviously, you know your way around Mexican food here. You know, a lot of people say you put sour cream in guacamole, or you just leave it as it is and put a little, you know, salt or something. What's your secret?
Well, I have to say that I don't think of guacamole as one recipe. I think of it as being lots of different recipes because avocados welcome all kinds of flavors. And during the holiday, I like to kind of mix it up and do something kind of cool with it. That's why I'm making one. You know, the tomatoes in the market aren't very good right now. So I'm making one with sun-dried tomatoes in it, some cilantro, a little grilled red onion, and some roasted red pepper. And then just scrape all of that stuff in with those beautiful, creamy avocados. And then you got to season it. And this is where I think I can share some tips with our viewers today. First of all, salt. Salt is an important
element.
And
is there a specific kind of salt you like kosher salt or sea salt?
Well,
what do you think?
I like to use kosher salt when I'm cooking at home because especially I can grab it with my fingers and then I know how much I'm getting. And then you got to add something that's tangy to it. Most people squeeze some lime or lemon juice in it. But for the holidays, I thought, why don't we mix it up? And I'm taking a little bit of roasted tomatillo salsa and adding that to it. Now, here's the place where a lot of people go wrong. They don't mash the avocados to the right consistency. Now, I'm using an old-fashioned potato masher here and I'm just going to go right down into the bowl with all the ingredients. And I'm not going to mash it too much. Certainly, I wouldn't want to put it all in the food processor.
A lot of people are used, to like mushy guacamole. Yeah. That's what you get at the store or often make yourself. You're saying try to avoid that.
Exactly. I want some of these beautiful chunks of the avocado. I mean, you've gone the extra mile to get beautiful avocados. Leave some chunks of it in there. But don't just think about my sun-dried tomato guacamole, which is what I have right here in the middle. But there's other things that you could do. Let your imagination go wild. I've got pepita or pumpkin seed guacamole here with a little red onion. This one's got some dried cranberries in it or just chop up the avocados themselves and put them on little tostadas. I've got some grilled steak tacos over here with a little bit of dice of avocado on the top of
it. Looks awesome.
Avocado is very useful for your holiday
parties. Rick, yesterday we had a local Mexican restaurant come in and they made chilaquiles. I think I'm saying that correctly. What are some other maybe brunch type items you could make for, say, a Christmas brunch that have a Mexican twist to it quickly?
Well, I have to say, huevos rancheros is my very favorite. And one of the things that you can do is do sunny side up eggs, put them out on a baking dish and keep them warm in the oven so that you can just finish those huevos rancheros just like that when your guests are all seated at the table. That's my absolute favorite dish for brunch.
And any money saving tips for the home cook you'd like to share with us?
Well, you can do just like what I've done here, is to feature something like sun-dried tomatoes, which can be expensive, as a flavor enhancer in something else that is less expensive. We've got some beautiful sangria here, which starts with a base of limeade, and then you add red wine to it, making the expense less for you.
Well, hey, thank you so much, Rick. Good to chat with you. We love the tips and love your Mexican recipes. Very good. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much.